To race five, the U.S. Pacing Championship worth $200,000 for free-for-all pacers. Artesian had no shot in the crown final from the bad post. Boulder Creek, the crown champion, parlayed the perfect Pierce drive into a career win. Royal Majesty set the fastest three quarters in track history under speed, dual pressure, and survived.
At the Rock, Royal Majesty with his good early speed there. Campbell urging him on. All-Star Blue Jean. Now it's Boulder Creek who guns out for Pierce on the inside. And Artesian looks to follow him. Protects rail position with good early speed around the first turn. Boulder Creek to the top. Royal Majesty and Campbell has the gas pedal down there. Artesian is third. It's All-American Capdor in the fourth position heading to the quarter. Then All-Star Blue Jean followed by Cam Cracker getting some whip taps. Arch Chip at the back. Too wide past the quarter. Boulder Creek there in 26-1. Boulder Creek, Royal Majesty, still grinding early here. Used hard to get that lead. Artesian is third under a snug hole down the back stretch. All-American Capdor fourth on the inside. All-Star Blue Jean is fifth. As Arch Chip goes to the outside, six gets underway there, and then it's Cam Cracker, and Royal Majesty did clear. It's Royal Majesty now, and Boulder Creek in the second spot with Artesian third, and now Pierce pulls pocket here and looks to reclaim off a half of 54. Campbell tried to slow it down there. Took a hold of Royal Majesty now as Boulder Creek is back on top. Boulder Creek now, and Arch Chip takes a shot at him here. And they are firing torpedoes at Boulder Creek, but he's trying to fend them off. It's Boulder Creek. Arch Chip now takes it to him and sticks a long neck in front. Royal Majesty is back in third now, and jammed up behind him is Artesian. To their outside is Cam Cracker trying to rally his All-Star Blue Jean, and then it's All-American Captor, and they're really going at it here. Eyeball to eyeball, three quarters. Arch Chip is taking it to Boulder Creek. Arch Chip looking for a big upset here. LeChance going to work. 1:22-1. Into the stretch drive. A fierce duel here. It's Arch Chip on the outside. Boulder Creek and Pierce is going to the well here and trying to find more. Boulder Creek trying to battle back. Arch Chip is winning the battle, and All-American Captor dives to the inside. Then it's Artesian. Arch Chip. Arch Chip does it here at 20-1 and 1:49.
Well, the odds are long, but you should never be surprised when Hall of Famer Mike LaChance gets the money in a big race. This son of Arts Place has been facing the shark and eating roadkill of late. And without those two, a shorter field and the right trip, he parlays that into victory.
Tell us a little bit about Arts Chip. Had you driven him before?
No, but I raced against him, and I know like about 3 weeks ago or a month ago, he was first up on the Four Stars Shark. And Joey told me that he's a little bit of a grinder. So, you know, I took him my best shot to come first over with him. Once I could get him close to the front, head-to-head with the horse in front, then he felt good after, you know, he kicked in the stretch a little bit.
And Arch Chip, the 54 and a half, but they had slowed down a little bit past that. You went and attacked the pace.
That's what I was. That was great for me because they came back at me the third quarter, so I could get close to the front easy. But he went a tough race. He was first up for a long time.
You've won the Hamiltonian twice in post position number one. Can it be three times with Cantab Hall today?
I sure hope so, but it's not over yet.
Well, while the Hamiltonian is the showcase, look out for the Mistletoe Chalet final. Rainbow Blue goes for 17 in a row next.